And welcome back to Fluffy's Store, where hopefully we get to go even further than last time. And continue! Brought to you by Bullshit, brought to you by this channel. And more freaking confusion. We haven't restocked for a week because I was injured, so I have to go to the wholesaler today. And make fun of people. Hopefully I do. I didn't go back to read. I went to Sherry with Sherry and the rest to open the store instead. Yeah, that's what you want me to do. On the other hand, I'll just sit in the back and just do my shit. Make fun of people on the internet. Sherry is standing happily between the shelves filled with various goods. Like what? Food? Before I knew it, there's a wonder variant of goods in my store. Okay, what happened? I want to know what happened. In great detail. By the way, whose turn is it for the Annalise Day? Now we know. Cheeky motherfucker. Just be glad it's your turn. Sherry goes outside happily and replaces the long rabbit ears with the tiny fox ears on the notice board. Yeah, that's what you want it to be. That's what you want my answer to be anyways. Of course! You're already lovely. Yeah, and you're trying to hit on all your employees? What kind of shallow? I'm not shallow! It's a compliment! I really blame this guy for it, because all I do is sleep. No one sees me outside anyways. Even if they do, they don't see me. Sherry points disapprovingly. Oh, why are you so pouty? You want me to compliment you again? No. I didn't think less of you. When you said I'm ugly, you should be grateful. Yeah, excluding your personality. Fine, get down to business, Perrin. What's on sale today? I still don't know what the heck a spicy stick is. Is it a freaking stick with a fucking jalapeno? Like, what the hell? My cell phone rings when I'm about to write this discount information on the notice board. Hello? Mr. Lynch, I'm your own Lee from the wholesaler company. Have you received from your drink? Yes. Thank you for the timely help that day. I've already recovered.
Oh yeah, it's my fault, I'm real sorry.
I was too careless, Mr. Lee. Don't take it to heart.
By the way, we have fresh stock pastries. Would you like to take a look, Mr. Lee?
Well, of course! Please, tell me more about what it could be. Well, these two question me quite a bit. And now the button doesn't want to work. You freaking asshole! Fresh pastries! What was the price? Sherry? Stop questioning me. I can already tell that Perrin's questioning, but I don't need both of you questioning me!
Where's his ankle, Joel? When are you coming over to see them? We can discuss the price when you're here.
Okay, I plan to restock today, too. I'll come once I've finished my work a bit later.
Okay. Do your work first. I won't bother you in that case.
He hangs up. I don't wanna. I need to check what I need for stock. Wait, where's the bear? I need frickin' Puff. Sherry pushes me outside, hopefully, as if she had heard the conversation. Damn it, Prime, you deserve more head pads! God damn it! Or it looks like she could kill me. I'm okay with both. You mean I am no longer needed at this store? I feel so sad. Okay, she just might kill us. Now we know the rabbit can kill. I'm gonna take that as you don't want any, and I'm not gonna pay for, and I'm not gonna give you your paycheck if you eat it. They're for sale, not for you to eat. You can't eat any of it. I also can't really bring either one of any of you because you're gonna eat like half the stock. Plus, you guys can't go very far from the chimes. Have fun. Fine. I'll go there immediately to look at the cakes. You've been. Yes. Help me look after the store. And now I have full reason to worry. Thank you, Perrin. The only mentally stable one so far. I brave the morning sun and arrive at the wholesaler food market street. Full of sweets.
Those are the cakes. They look great. It's made from yogurt by using a new technology.
You mean they just give it freaking yogurt filling? Mr. Lee has been waiting for me at his shop and promote his cake the minute he saw me. Yeah. They look quite appetizing. May I try it?
Certainly. Go ahead. We got guns too. Please tell me you're not gonna kill anyone.
Then the wholesaler takes two cakes and gives one to me. He put the other one into his mouth. Mean piece of cake? good. It has that yogurt taste. Doesn't feel as dry as ordinary cakes. And these cakes have been that pure sweetness in them.
Yeah, they're honey cakes, so they taste sweet, yummy, and healthy. Occasionally, I take a few for my meals, so when I'm too busy.
Hopefully you pay for it too. I don't want this dude to go out of business. Have you sold them to the other stores? How did they go?
Nope. If Mr. Lin is agreeable, you'll be the first to sell them.
That is actually pretty damn good. I'll be the first one to sell them. Take that, you bastards! It starts assaulting the other shop owners. I'm still the first one to sell them.
Yeah, Mr. Lin, the customer traffic interest has increased recently. I hope you can help me promote these cakes. I'll definitely give you a fair price, which will benefit you.
Actually, that's pretty damn good. We get the name, the price, and it works.
I hesitate in front of these boxes of cakes. There aren't many, and they didn't seem to be made by a large enterprise.
Well, the good thing is that I'd like to go at the minimum, and if people like it, I'll go higher.
Yes. Be honest, one of my relatives made these cakes in the store. I thought they were great, so I invested some money to upgrade his assembly line. Now he can mass produce them, but I have no way to sell them. So I thought of asking Mr. Lin to help in selling them.
Wise choice.
I'll sell you
$5 above everything else. Not a lot, but certainly worth it.
I see, but my store is small. I can't promise you. Don't say that. Your store is well known. Many foreign tourists would especially visit that place. I think they will definitely sell while you're in your store. But Mr. Ling, if you're afraid of my produce aren't good enough, I won't force you either.
No. I'm actually interested in source for a few specialty items, after all. My store only has commonly average items. And isn't that different from other convenience stores?
This is also a good thing. You could sell this shit and people go, what the fuck? I don't want to know more.
I see. That's really good in that case.
Yeah, it can force you out there and make you even better, so take it! You get money! It'll take maybe a week or two for all the other stores to kind of take notice. Oh, fully.
Let's talk about the deals for the details first. Good. I'll book a table and we can discuss it over slowly at the table.
Perfect. Oh, what? What an occasion. What's the occasion? Please tell me you're gonna get me a couple of drinks first.
We can grab a beer too. And more or less from the apology for me.
So you are grabbing me a drink or two, man? I like you even more. I will agree to that. Do we get to see what he looks like?
Mr. Lee gives me a lift back to the convenience store after the meal. Sherry pops her head out from the glass doors and rushes out upon seeing me return.
You really just wanted that fucking cake, didn't you? You greedy bastard!
Look. I smugly take a sample out of my bag and wave them around to Cherry.
No, I will not! As long as you share with Puffing Purin!
Do you want to eat? She's moving along with my hand, and even shaking her tail, she's like a starving fox, begging to be fed. God damn it.
チが当たるよ。
God damn it. You want one too. Yo, give it. I give it. God damn it, Pump. Man, you're weak. Damn it, Link. Come on, bro. Why you doing this, man? Puff came from somewhere and grabbed my wrist.
どれどれ?
Damn it, alarm. No, I don't want you to see. This is alarm. Then she takes the cake and swallows it in one gulp. It's like the best way to end the episode too. So I'll see all you guys next time, and I hope all of you have a great one of a time. And I hope all of you have fun too. I can see you guys next time, man.